Okay, today I'm going to review the product Infiray. Okay, this is the second time I review this, and this time it comes with the micro teleconverter. Actually, it's the macro lens. Remember the 6 Pro that we use? We have a macro lens on it. So now if I put on the lens, everything will be blur, of course, because the lens is make the object bigger. So we are gonna do closing in. Then you can see every capacitor resistor, you know, that big. Okay, if I take away the lens, everything become blur and you need to raise up your distance, everything becomes small. This is the maximum zoom already. So put on the lens and we can use like this close. So let's open it and see. Well, once open, we can see there's a little box in here, pretend to be Apple iPhone. Pocket and the instruction. This is the manual. By the way, this product is Type C, not for iOS yet. So we have to scan the code and then get the software. So there's also extension cable on here, the Type C. If I compare with 6 Compact Pro, the size, so this is the macro lens that they gave me. With this, we can challenge the 6 Compact Pro. Without these things, we can't even see the iPhone components. So. Okay. And calling the advertising, they are suitable for bigger things. But this time, they sent me together with the lens to challenge my 6 Compact Pro. To challenge the mobile phone repair field. Okay, so yep, as we can see, the lens is unprotected. Okay, only protected from the front, but not from here. So be careful when you open it. So this thing is magnetic. I can see there's a peg on here. Yep, it's magnetic. Strange that there's a little dirt on there. Alright, so this lens is so easy to put on. It's magnetic. Just clip on it like this. It doesn't come loose. So that's it for the opening. Okay, once you open the box, the first thing you notice is the instruction. In the front page is Chinese. So behind is English. It says search for P2 Pro in the application market. By the way, this thing is not support iOS at all, only Android. So I'm gonna show you inside the Play Store. If you search for P2 Pro, for sure you will get it. It is the only one in the Play Store. And I can see the last updated is 20 September. It is just few weeks ago, so this is the latest version I'm testing. So the icon is look like this. Open it up and it say please plug in the device. First, I'm gonna use the device without the macro lens on top. Let's see how is the performance. Allow to access. Yes. So, of course, we can't see anything because there's no object and thermal on the table. So let's see my hand. I'm just testing the motion. Okay, let's see the refresh rate. You see, it's lagging. So the shuttering is just about 1/2 second. Okay. By the way, the motion is enough, it is fast enough. I am going to take the video. Well, it seems like you can see my wind. If I side by side compare to the 6 Compact Pro, the first thing we notice is the knocking sound. So every 2 seconds, you will hear the knocking sound. This one, it is almost silent, but it is still there. I can barely hear it. Well, as I say in the video, without the macro lens, you cannot repair any smartphone. Okay, so if you look at the device, you can't even see the capacitor. It's all blur. Okay, I will show you. So I have an iPhone 6s in here, everything is working. Only the CPU has been reballed before. Okay, CPU and the RAM. Now I'm gonna turn on this iPhone 6s because if I turn it on, it should have thermal on top of the CPU. So now I am going to look at it without the macro lens. Okay, the macro lens is still in my hand. As you can see, it is all blur. I can't see anything. Okay, the whole section is get the heating. And do not forget, it is not adjustable like the 6 Compact Pro. With a 6 Compact Pro, I still can adjust the lens. So let's look at the power IC. Yep, as I expected, we couldn't see anything without the macro lens. So this is why you need this. Put on it. Well, some more it is magnetic. It seems really high class. It looks pretty. So after you put on, we can see all the capacitor, resistor, the IC, they are clear. But the weakness of this is the distance. If you look at the distance between the lens and the board, it's so close. So let's compare with the 6 Compact Pro. So the distance, as you can see, is much more higher. I'm at this height, but I still can see every caps and the resistor. Okay. Some more, I can use the adjustable lens here to increase the distance, you know. Okay. I cannot get too close with a 6 Compact Pro, but this will be enough. So the most important features I need is the refresh rate. Hi everyone, I'm Lim. In case you don't know, I've been using the 6 thermal camera more than you imagine. By looking at the YouTube date, actually few years before that video, I already have using it. It is this one. Until today, I have reviewed many thermal camera, especially they are from China. You must be wondering why I didn't upload those videos, because most of the reason that failed to challenge my 6 Compact Pro. Do not forget, my field is only repair the iPhone logic board. If anyone is repairing the smartphone, it is the same thing. I'm not talking about the laptops or bigger board. The size of their components are totally different. We are much more smaller. So based on my experience to repair the smartphone, it is the resolution, refresh rate, how fast he can detect the instant heat up as this video. Let's say the shot is just 1/2 second or maybe less. Exactly that moment is still able to capture by the thermal camera. It is considered fast. There are many brands I have reviewed most of them that fail at the refresh rate. The refresh rate is too slow. If they're failing at this, it will cost us at least 50% of the special shot you cannot repair. So this is why I'm still using the SIG thermal camera until today. As you can see, today we have a new challenger. This time he has added another part, which is the macro lens. They call it teleconverter. So this product is very challenging to the SIG Compact Pro because of the price tag. In this video, I will show you a rare case, a repair case that is water damaged, and we will locate the shot with a thermal camera. So enough saying, let's begin. Okay, I have a rare case in here. This is the iPhone 6s that is water damaged. Almost every day I have repaired the water damage, and most of them they are the logic board problem. Shot cannot turn on. So this is a typical case that I will put the thermal camera into test. First, I will going to use the power supply to see what is the response. Is it shot? Plug in the cable, turn on the power supply. Okay, as we can see, even before 2.0 volt, it already leaked all the current, full shot. So unplugged from our supply, and we look at the microscope. I already noticed there is some rusty things on top of the shield. As usual, you're gonna do the visual inspection to know the place that affected. I believe one of my video, I already have taught you that you're gonna to note down the place that affected. Because after you have cleaned it, usually it will still short. Especially beneath the IC. I believe this is the Touch ID IC, power for the fingerprint Touch ID. And these two caps, they are heavily corroded. So continue. And the baseband. By the way, my objective is to turn on the device, not to repair everything, because the owner is requested to recover the data only, not going to spend so much to repair it all. After all, this is a very old device. Alright, that will be enough. First, I'm gonna try to clean it. Okay, the cleaning is done. We still need to remove the shield, right? It's best we remove the top of here. Don't forget, the water always can enter from the hole. As we can see inside, they are affected. Need to clean. Okay, now to power up the device. Okay, as I expected, it is still short. Okay, that's why I tell you, you put on the cleaning machine, it is useless. Because the component, they are affected, you need to remove it. It is damaged. So this is the point, we are going to use the thermal camera. I am going to use the P2 Pro. Of course, the macro lens is needed. The first problem of the P2 Pro is the distance control. It is fixed, it is not adjustable, and we need to be very close. Okay, I will begin the recording. You can see the image quality before it is turned on. Okay, injecting the wood, it is short. I will put it about 1.8. It is drawing about 900 mA. So the place that get heat up should be obvious. So definitely it's from behind. We can see there's a cap. The auto tracking system has already pointed at it. Okay. Let me show you where he is pointing. He is showing this guy is the problem. Yep, obviously. If we look at the microscope, this cap one side of the solar pack is totally burned out. Okay? When you see the thermal camera, he's the one get the heat, then confirm he's the short. Okay, now that we already know this capacitor is the problem, we are going to use the SICK thermal camera. Okay, just do the blinking. So now, what I'm going to do is remove this cap.
Weapons activated.
Yep, I'm not going to measure the cap because 100% is the problem. What's left is we're going to power up with the cable again to see. Okay, I didn't expect only one cap is the problem. So since the voltage is handling no problem, I am going to press the power button. So then we can know whether it can turn on or not. Yep, it is able to power up. No problem. So what now is I'm going to connect the screen. The screen connector, it is still very clean, you know, it still can use. Okay, turn on again. The phone is turning on but no display. So possible the screen is damaged. I am going to take another screen. Turn it off. Okay. This is a new screen. Yep, the LCD is damaged. Ta-da! Even a 250 USD thermal camera, it can do the job like this. Well, without thermal camera, you really cannot call this a easy money, you know. If I'm not taking the video, it should be in 5 minutes. Less than 5 minutes, I already earned the money.
To the conclusion of the video, a thermal camera in this price, with this performance, I really have nothing to complain. Even I want to complain something about it. It is the lens that cannot be adjusted. But it doesn't stop us to detect the problem. It is just too close to the logic board. The distance between the thermal camera after you put on the macro lens and the logic board is too close. Which means if you are repair the iPad is a bigger board, you need to move around a lot. If the lens is adjustable or we can raise up the distance, then we can cover a lot of area. Not too much, just a little higher. And the second thing I don't like is it doesn't support the iOS. It is only available in the Type-C, which you are going to use the Android. So, if any beginners that are looking for the thermal camera and your budget is not that high, you can use this one. Below my video in the description, there's a link. By the way, I don't get commission if you buy from there. Inside the link, you will notice there's a two model, okay? P2 and P2 Pro. The only difference is the temperature range. The refresh rate, the resolution, both of them same. But the price difference is too small. If money is not the issue, okay, you go for a higher spec. So I guess this will be all and I see you on the next video. Bye.